Today, we're going to look at brains and vats.
Maximus talks about biology.
Comparative brains. So this is a fish brain. This is a carp. These are its eyeballs. Here's an amphibian brain. It's a frog. This is a snake brain. This is a pigeon brain. And this is a rabbit brain.
Wow.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Eyeballs are particularly notable. So here, we've got cat brain. It's the brain of a cat. Cat brain. Look at that brain in a jar. It's pretty cool. So the cat brain looks kind of like a human brain, just smaller. It's got similar folds. This is a dog brain. Particularly notable are the olfactory bulbs up here. You can see that the dog cares a lot about smell. Those olfactory bulbs are really prominent. Other than the olfactory bulbs, looks pretty much like a brain, a human brain. There's the cerebellum. Yeah, so here's a dog brain. Here's a rabbit brain. Rabbit brain. So the rabbit brain doesn't have nearly as much folding in the cortex. It's got a pretty smooth cortex because it's a rodent. Rodents have smooth cortex. This is a freeze-dried sheep brain. It's really light because all the water's been removed from it. And it's pretty crazy. Here's the cerebellum, cortex of a sheep. Sheep brain in my hands. It's really not that big, you know, like compared to the size of my hand. Here's my hand. Here's a sheep brain. That's sheep's have tiny brains. Tiny sheep brain. Yeah. Got two sheep brains. They can talk to each other. Hi, what are you doing? I'm a sheep brain. I'm dead and freeze-dried. And in a lab wrapped in plastic, because humans are curious about things, and when they're curious, they freeze dry them and wrap them in plastic. So that's what human brains do to other brains. It's a strange thing that brains do to other brains. Yes. This is a chimp brain. See, there's the cerebellum, there's the folds. It looks very much like a human brain, it's just smaller. Smaller. It's a brain in a vat. Yep. Brain in a vat. Used to be in a chimp. Now it's wrapped in formaldehyde. This is a macaque. It's a monkey brain. It's pretty tiny, but brain is a brain. And brain in a vat. It's a real thing that people do to brains. It's really strange. This is a dolphin brain. Dolphin brains are really strange because they're pretty large as far as brains go, but the folds in the cortex are much smaller than in a human brain. That's because the cortex itself in a dolphin is thinner, and they think it's because dolphins have to dive underwater and there's oxygen constraints in the cortex, and so it needs to be thinner. At least that was the just-so story that I heard. But anyway, there's a dolphin brain in a vat, so that's unusual. Brains and vats. That's the theme of today. I wonder how old this brain is. And this, of course, is our grand finale. This is a human brain, half of one. This used to be a person with a self and thoughts and dreams. And now it's a brain in the vat so that I can be a person with thoughts and dreams and dream about brains. Yeah, it's a pretty surreal experience to hold the brain of another human being in my hands. You can see the cerebral cortex. There is the cerebellum. This is a human brain.
I think the mummy lion body. If you go here, so like here you would have the
then you guys can check yourself, okay? And ask me questions.